I'm from Mountain View High School, and I spent my internship at Twin Rivers Middle School in an eighth grade language arts classroom under the mentorship of Ms. Kimberly Harder. So far, I've completed 62 hours of my internship. By the end of the semester, I should have completed around 75. My responsibilities are different each time I go. Most often, I'm responsible for facilitating small group conversations. The class is split up into 7 groups of 3 to 5 students, and I'll just kind of walk around and observe and prompt discussion if they get stuck. Ms. Harder's also given me the opportunity to deliver like 10-minute mini lessons, and later this week I'm actually delivering my first full-blown lesson that we've been working on together since before Thanksgiving. We also have an overflow room across the hall from Ms. Harder's classroom where I can take groups of students when she asks, whether for, you know, if they need extra help that she can't really offer them super individualized help, or if they miss something and they can't participate in what they're doing in class that day, or if they're just disrupting their surroundings and really need to get their work done, I'm allowed to take them either individuals or groups of students to the overflow room. Ms. Harder will also call on me sometimes during class and ask me to share experiences that I've had in high school, because students love to pull the, I'm never going to use this when they're learning, myself included, but I can normally tell them that what they're learning in that class and the skills that they're developing will come in handy later.
That's awesome.
When they're independently working or when they're taking a test, you know, Ms. Harder has things to do, so just to have a presence in the room, I'll kind of walk around and make sure no one's cheating or anything. And then lastly, just whatever she needs me to do, I do, because my job is to learn about the teaching profession and to be an extra set of hands for her, so whatever I can do to make her job easier is fine by me. It's really true when people say that teachers have more homework than students do, and Ms. Harder and I would joke about her stacks of paper that would multiply every time we turned our backs, and I know that that's something I would have to expect if I go into the teaching profession. And I've also learned that it's really important to build relationships with kids. And she makes a conscious effort to say, you know, have a good day, so-and-so, to every single student as they leave. And I know that that's something that I really like about my teachers, that they care about me as a person. So I try and imitate that, too, with the students and make them feel, you know, as comfortable as possible. I've written about confidence on a lot of my timesheets, but that's probably my biggest area of growth, because I was really nervous to talk to the middle schoolers for some reason, especially to deliver a lesson. But, you know, they're patient and respectful, and Ms. Harder is really encouraging. So I've been able to build my own confidence, and I'm thankful because I can use that no matter what career I end up finding. And I've also learned to prompt students to think critically instead of just handing them answers, which Ms. Harder encourages, because we don't want to handhold them since they're about to go to high school. And since I'm only a few years older than them, and my sister is in middle school, so I'm around middle schoolers a lot, it was hard for me to not be my normal self and to speak professionally to them, but I learned how to balance that too through this semester. I think as of now, I'm leaning towards pursuing other careers other than education, but that still have an education aspect. The Bureau of Labor Statistics says that job opportunities for high school teachers will increase, but really only for math and science teachers, and that makes me kind of nervous because I would want to teach high school language arts, and I don't want to graduate college with nowhere to go. So I'm trying to find a career that will still let me work with kids and feel like I'm teaching without not having a place to be employed. Oh, I've had many experiences that I love, and I've enjoyed my time, but there are two that have stood out to me. The first is I've gotten to work with a child who is diagnosed with Asperger's, and we were writing an essay on animal conservation, and he loves animals, so I was able to tap into that to get him to craft his arguments. To see that click for him was really cool. And then the second, I was just explaining something to a group of kids, and as I walked away, I overheard one of them turn to his friends and say, "She's going to be really good at this one day." And that boosted my confidence for sure.
I love it.
I'm really grateful to have participated in this internship. Ms. Harder had me when I was in 7th grade, and she changed my life and sparked my interest in education. And I hope that I've been doing the same for the students, or at least just being, you know, a cool student teacher to have in the room. I don't know. But I'm really grateful, and I'm excited to learn more about another career next semester.
Good. All right, thank you.